What is up, YouTube? It has been a long time since I made a YouTube video, but I am back with a tutorial actually on how to create and delete registry values in Visual Basic. And today we're going to be doing a Visual Studio 2019. We're going to create a WIM Forms application and do the Windows Forms app. We're going to call registry values. And we're going to do .NET Framework 4.6. I'm not sure if this works in lower versions, but I'm using 4.6. I believe they're up to 4.8 now. So anyway, we're going to double click on the title bar right here and create a new line up here. We're going to do import system.security.principal. And now we're going to do a quick test to see if we're running as an administrator. So we'll do dim identity equals Windows identity dot get current. And we're going to go down a line. We're going to type dim, we'll call this principal equals new Windows principal. Windows principal, and in parentheses we'll do identity. We're gonna go down a line. Dim is elevated as boolean equals, go down a line, and this is going to be our value that returns true or false depending on if you're an administrator or not. So yeah, we're gonna go down a line and type in principal dot is in role, and then in parentheses we'll do Windows. I can't type today. Windows built-in role dot administrator. And we're gonna go down a line, and this is where we check the value. So if not is elevated, then if it's not elevated, we want to restart the application as an administrator. So in order to do that, we will type in dim start info as process start info. Equals new process start info. I'll do start info dot use shell execute equals true. Do start info dot working directory equals environment dot current directory, which is going to get the directory of the executable that's running. Start info dot verb. And we're going to call it run as. And then we're going to do try dim p as process equals process dot start, and then in parentheses start info. And then catch as x is exception. I'll just type return. After the end try, you want to type application exit. And so that will just say that, hey, after the prompt comes up, you want to close it. And then, so now it's saying if it is elevated, here's the else thing, and we're not going to put anything down there because if it's elevated, we just want it to keep running. So now we're going to create two buttons. We're going to create one called create test value. And then this one we're going to call delete test value. All right, so now we have our two little buttons here. Okay, there we go, whatever. Anyway, so we're gonna go into create test value right here. We are going to do my.computer.registry.localmachine dot create subkey, and we are going to call the subkey software / 1a test. And that is going to, I could actually show you in one moment, that is going to place the registry value right up here, not in Adobe, but in your software thing. Now, real quick, if you are running a 64-bit Windows, you will need to make sure to specify that this is a 64-bit application, because if you don't, it will place it in this WOW6432 node. That is where all the registry values go. Otherwise, if it's a 32-bit application. So in order to change that real quick, we'll go up here to Configuration Manager, and we'll just change this to where it says any CPU. We will click New, and then it's already has x64 selected, so we'll hit OK, and then just close that. And now we are in 64-bit. Debug and publish doesn't really matter. It really just changes the folder that it outputs in. I don't think it does anything else, to be honest. I'm making a lot of bold claims here. All right, so anyway, create the subkey right there. Then we're going to do my.computer.registry.setValue. And for in here, we're going to, we'll actually have to type it out, but hkey_local_machine\software\1a test. And then we're going to do a space and then a comma here. And we're going to, this is going to be the name of the value that we're, or the name of the string that we're going to create. So we will call it test string. And then another comma, and then the actual value, we will just call it sum data. And now we will go back to form one here. We will go to delete test value. And this, we're just gonna have it delete the folder that it created. So we will do mycomputer.registry.localmachine.deleteSubkey. And as you see in there, you could also do delete value if you just want to do a specific value. But we're just going to do the subkey just to speed things up. Software 1a test. And I believe that is all we need. So we are going to debug now. Okay, so I forgot an important thing right here. So we are going to add a line in here that says start info. File name, and we will do application dot executable path. Okay, so now if we debug this one more time, I believe everything will cooperate. All right, so we'll create test value. And it didn't return an error, so that's good. So we will refresh. And here's our 1A test right here. And we'll quick go into the WOW6432 node, and you can see there's nothing in there. So anyway, we'll go into our 1A test. Here's our test string. Here's some data. Now if we want to delete that, we will hit delete test value. We will go back over here and refresh. And there we go. Our folder is completely gone now. There we go. I should have caught that right away. Make sure that you're getting the UAC prompt right here, the user account thing. You want to make sure you're running as an administrator. All right, well, thank you for watching. Much appreciated. Show some support in terms of Just like the video, it's free. Thanks, guys. Yeah, if you want to see more tutorials, you could suggest them down in the comments, other things you want to see, or just wait until I come up with some crazy ideas, because I'm sure I'll have plenty. Well, thanks for watching, guys.